Stir frying felt a bit tricky and awkward when I first started out with it. I found that working with high heat and moving quickly really stressed me out, and on top of that, every recipe seemed to call for a different order of steps. The last few weeks, I made it my goal to conceptualize some kind of rubric to apply to all things stir fry. After cooking and consuming an astonishing amount of Sichuan stir fries, I was finally able to break down the process into three major steps: the setup, the primary cook, and saucing slash finishing.
First you gotta set yourself up.
So this is the step that contains the bulk of our work and is by far the most important to ensure a smooth sailing stir fry. Our goal is to have everything completely ready to go for our primary cook. So this step includes marinating, cutting and measuring ingredients, and the first round of cooking for twice cooked dishes. In her book, The Food of Sichuan, Fuchsia Dunlop says marinades are often added to fish and meat to dispel any lingering raw tastes and to give the food a base flavor. Often these marinades include tenderizing agents as well, stuff like baking soda, egg whites, or special tenderizer powders. I'll be covering this more in my advanced stir fry video. The central tenet of cutting your primary ingredients is to prep them into similarly sized and shaped pieces. This ensures they cook evenly and the stir fry is easy to eat when you're done. Mismatched shapes of various ingredients give a stir fry a weird vibe that I'm just not into. As for aromatics, typically some combination of ginger, scallions, and garlic, the same rule applies. These are normally minced, sliced, or rough chopped depending on the recipe. For those new to stir frying, I highly recommend you slice your aromatics fairly thick. The large pieces are a bit more forgiving when it comes to burning in the high heat of a wok. At this point, we'll also measure out any additional ingredients we may need, such as Shaoxing wine, oil, and the sauce slash seasonings for your dish. However, as you get more comfortable with the technique, I highly recommend getting pour spouts or squeeze bottles for your oil, wine, and soy sauce. Stir frying is just way more fun when you don't need to measure out every single little thing. And last but not least, we'll also do our first round of cooking for twice cooked dishes and blanch tough veggies during this step. But again, I'll be covering more of these techniques in my next video.
The primary cook.
So now that we've done all the prep and our mise en place is all laid out, I want to cover one quick point before we cook the dang thing. When it comes to stir frying, heat control is the name of the game. Our goal is to essentially cook everything as swiftly as possible over high heat while not burning anything. So instead of controlling the heat of the wok by adjusting the burner, we'll control it by putting it on or pulling it off the heat source or adding ingredients. So if you're ever worried your wok is too hot, just add a splash of Shaoxing wine or lift the wok off the flame. And to stop things from burning, we keep everything moving the whole time we're cooking. When you master heat control, you master stir frying. The first step of every stir fry is to create a semi-nonstick surface on your wok through a technique called Lang Yao. To do this, get your wok ripping hot and add a portion of the cooking oil, swirling it around the surface of the wok. Next, we begin to add ingredients to the wok. Often the first thing added are your fresh aromatics to flavor the cooking oil. This can be tricky for beginners as it is very easy to burn them in the hot wok, so I'd recommend adding them at a later point if you're new to stir frying. If you feel like you are ready to add them first, create your nonstick surface, then add the rest of your cooking oil the recipe calls for and immediately put the aromatics in. Cook them for about 10 seconds and keep them moving continuously so they don't burn. As for your primary ingredients, I highly recommend cooking each of them separately and then combining them back together at the end, especially if you're cooking for more than two people. It's just way easier to focus on cooking one ingredient at a time, plus it works way better for the power output on home stoves.
Ugh, another one of these things, saucing and finishing.
And the last step would be to incorporate any of your last minute add-ins. This is stuff like herbs and scallion greens, seasonings, sauce, and finishing oils like sesame or Sichuan peppercorn. Sauces obviously vary widely from recipe to recipe, but I'll be including a basic stir fry sauce, which is sort of a riff on a recipe by Chinese Cooking Demystified. The link to their channel will be in my description below. All right, that's a whole bunch of info. So let's walk through these steps with a super basic bell pepper stir fry so we can kind of get a big picture idea of what's going on. For step one, I'll cut my ingredients up. Here I'll mince my garlic and ginger, thinly slice my scallion greens, and thickly julienne some bell peppers. Then I'll measure out my sauce ingredients using the recipe in the description, and finally get everything laid out all nicey nice.
Now I'll get my wok searing hot and toss a portion of my oil around in it, creating that non-stick surface we talked about earlier. I notice my wok is a little too hot, so I cool it down a bit by pulling it off the flame. Next, my peppers go in. I like a little char on my peppers, but I'll keep them moving a bit so they don't burn. After about 30 seconds, I'll scrape those up the side of the wok and toss in my garlic and ginger, cooking them for about 15 seconds. It is super important to keep them moving around because they will 100% burn if you don't. Then I'll incorporate them in with my peppers, again keeping everything moving so nothing burns. At this point, I'm almost ready to sauce, but again, I think my wok is a little too hot, so I'll add a splash of Shaoxing wine to cool it off before adding my sauce. Then in goes the sauce, I'll toss it around a little bit and let the heat thicken up the starch. Fold in my scallion greens and then pour it over some rice. The whole process only took about 90 seconds from start to finish. This is what I consider to be the core fundamentals of a good stir fry. So try a couple of single ingredient stir fries out, and when you're feeling ready, come check out my advanced stir fry video. Please consider liking and subscribing if you dug the video. It really helps me out and I would really appreciate it. Later, nerds.
Crash Course, Crash Course Kitchen. Crash Course, Crash Course Kitchen. It's hot.